Did you know 100 wasn't always that many? And 1 billion wasn't always that many? There are fascinating stories behind the words we use for whopping great numbers, and that's what this video is all about. No knowledge of maths required, just a curiosity about the language we speak. How much is a myriad? How many in a milliard? How big's a British billion? And what on earth is a swollen 100? Will you know the answers to these questions by the end of this video? You can count on it. Now, before we get going, I just wanted to say another quick thank you if you're one of my new subscribers. If you're not, why not change that and hit the subscribe button now? I've been enjoying getting suggestions, by the way, for subjects to cover too. So if you have one, pop it in the comments below. Right, let's crunch some numbers. Now, we're going to start off with what I think is the smallest big number, because, you know, remember when you were a kid and having 100 of anything seemed like an unimaginably large amount? So I'm similarly hoping to blow your mind with the history of this one, because I love it. So where did the humble word 100 come from? Well, it goes way back. In Old English, which was being spoken, you know, around 1,000 years ago, we had the word hund, which meant 100. The word actually has the same ancient root as the Latin word centum and the Greek hekaton, both of which mean 100 as well. But Old English also developed this other, slightly longer word, which was spelt in many ways, one of which was hundred. The new letters on the end were a very old Germanic suffix that basically meant reckoning or counting. So the word hundred actually means something along the lines of count of hundred. This is probably something to do with how the word was used as a noun. You would ask for a count of hundred of fish or loaves of bread, or whatever, to stress that you were asking for a quantity as opposed to, you know, literally asking for the number, I guess. So how many items would you get if you asked for 100 of them? This many? Well, don't be so sure, because back then you'd have probably ended up with this many. It was common for Germanic tribes to use a 100 that was based on 6 score. A score is 20, so that's 6 times 20, 120, instead of 5 score, 5 times 20, which is what 100 is to us today. This 100 that is actually 120 is sometimes referred to as a long 100 nowadays, or great 100, to help differentiate. The 100 that we know and love is sometimes called a short or small 100, and spread to the Norsemen in the north in the wake of Christianity. Now, for a long time, these two definitions of 100 competed, to the extent where you would actually need to specify which one you were working with. The long 100 was actually in use until way later than you might expect. I mean, look at this quote discussing trading fabrics from the 16th century. "The 100 of canvas and of linen cloth is and containeth 120 to the 100. That's 100, but it's 120. In fact, the long 100 didn't fall fully out of use until the 18th century. Bonus fact, another old name for 120 was twelfty, which will come as a fun little tidbit for fans of the British comedy The League of Gentlemen.
Candles! Twelfty!
Accounting based on 12 has echoes, actually, in modern English. Have you ever thought it strange that we only start adding teen to the end of numbers when we get to 13? It's the same in other Germanic languages as well. We have a special word for 11 and a special word for 12. That's because, you know, the basic count was not 1 to 10, it was 1 to 12. Okay, now let's step things up tenfold and head over to our next big number, the 1,000. This also goes back to Old English, which had the word thousand, featuring our new favourite Old English letter, thorn. Check out my video about lost letters of the English alphabet to learn more about that. I'll pop a link at the end. Stay here for now. Now, thousand, or thousand, is thought to be made up of two elements which have their roots in the Proto-Indo-European language. Remember, that's the language that's our best guess at the common ancestor of all manner of European and Asian languages. And etymologists believe that those roots, which I have no idea how to say, and I'm not going to attempt to say, and I also suspect that no one in the world knows truly how to say them, were that, which means swell, and that, which is an ancestor of both the word ten and of 100, actually. So basically, 1,000 is a swollen 100. The Anglo-Saxons probably didn't have many occasions where they needed to count to 1,000. So it's likely that the word 1,000 more just refers to a big number, in the same way that mille in Latin and kilioi in ancient Greek are thought to have started off with a more vague meaning than the 1,000 that they eventually went on to mean. Now, that phenomenon of going from the vague to the specific works both ways, as our next big number shows. Now, myriad is a word used these days in English to mean many. I have myriad unopened letters on my desk. It's never good news, is it? Opening them just makes me anxious. I drank myriad beers at the stag do last weekend. I did, and frankly, I feel terrible about it. We also did paintballing, and that's why I've got bruises all up my arm. I obviously wasn't very good at it, was I? Anyway, another example, there are a myriad of reasons why you should hit like and subscribe under this video, for example. A quick note here, if you're wondering whether to use a myriad of or just myriad, a general rule is that if you're using it as an adjective, it's myriad. If you want to use myriad as a noun, it's a myriad of something. Anyway, we generally use the word myriad to mean a lot of something, but actually, its root word is rather more specific. It comes from the ancient Greek word myrias, which didn't just mean lots, it meant specifically 10,000. Now, you'll occasionally come across it being used in English to mean specifically that number too. So, just to confirm, when I said I had myriad beers, I was in fact exaggerating a little bit. Oh, quick one. When I hit 10,000 subscribers on YouTube a few days ago, I popped a little community post on YouTube about the word myriad, and I just wanted to give a shout out to Russ Johnson, who pointed out that as well as percent, meaning per 100, you can also have per mille for one in 1,000, or per myriad for one in 10,000. You can, but it's pretty rare. No, gar nicht.
So, at this point in the recording, I was interrupted in a very friendly fashion by one of the local Berliners, who was extremely keen that I try on his hat. He decided that I was Polish. I tried on his sunglasses as well.
Yes, good. Yeah, fast, so good.
Made a friend. Now, we've done very well to keep moving up in multiples of 10, so let's keep that up and crack on to our next big number, the lakh. Now, it's entirely possible you have never heard this word. Lakh has its roots in Sanskrit and is actually a Hindi word, but it is used all the time by millions of English speakers in India, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka to mean 100,000. It's really common to see Indian newspaper reports, for example, talking about lakhs of rupees. It's so commonly used because of the different way that countries in the region write out numbers, where in many parts of the world a million will be written like that. Well, in India, it will be written out like that, or 10 lakhs. The same system also gives us another word when we hit 10 million or 100 lakhs, and that is a crore, which, like lakh, has its roots in the ancient Indian language of Sanskrit. So now we're into the millions. Let's make a quick stop there. So million is the youngest word we've come across so far. Why? Because the ancient Greeks had no number higher than 10,000, the myriad, and the Romans only bothered to go as high as 100,000. To express a million, they'd have had to say their equivalent of 1,000,000. Million is actually thought to come from the Italian word milione, now spelt with just one L, meaning a great thousand. We already know that mille was the Latin for thousand. English acquired million from Old French, which was brought over by William the Conqueror and his crew back in the 11th century. Again, I've got a video all about that. Check it out a bit later on. Now, next up, the milliard. Now, this is a word that will be familiar to you if you speak another European language like French or German, but if you only speak English, you may never have seen it before. Instead, you probably know this number as a billion. So pretty much the entire English-speaking world now recognizes this number as a billion. It's 1,000 million, but this wasn't always the case. And in fact, It's really quite a new thing. Until as recently as the 1970s, the British government used the word billion to mean a million million, one followed by 12 zeros, and what is sometimes these days referred to as a British billion. But by the 1970s, the American billion, the one followed by nine zeros, had become so widely used elsewhere, the Brits just gave up and made it official. But before they decided to embrace the American billion, they were calling 1,000 million something else. A milliard. Now, after I posted this fact on TikTok a while back, loads of people from all over the world actually got in touch to say that in their native language, 1,000 million was still called something akin to a milliard. English is the outlier on this one, and frankly, I do not like it. We should change 1,000 million back to a milliard and make a billion, a million million, like it also is in other languages. And while we're at it, let's bring back the billiard too. And let's have the trilliard back as well while we're at it. Agree or disagree? Tell me in the comments. Well, now we're into the realm of the ludicrously massive numbers. Let's talk about the googol. Now that's one followed by 100 zeros. Now this word's not as ripe for linguistic geekery as the other ones we've had because it's frankly just too young. It's said to have been invented by the young nephew of the American mathematician Edward Kasner at his request when he was looking for a funky name in the middle of the last century. There's also a googolplex, which is one followed by a googol of zeros. The plex bit means to the power of, so googolplex means to the power of Google. And some clever clogs also came up with a googolplexplex, which is one followed by a googolplex of zeros. But now we're just getting silly, aren't we? And on that unfathomable note, I think I've gone far enough. Thanks a lot for watching. If you've enjoyed this, hit like and subscribe and click that bell thing as well. And you know, why not check me out on Twitter and TikTok as well? There's even more stuff from me on there. Until next time, take care.